So guys, it has finally happened. We have got the announcement we've been waiting for. We have the announcement of the October event, and it's happening on a Monday. What on earth is all of this about, and what are we expected to see at this event? Well, today, I'm going to reveal all. Hi guys, it's Matt here. So finally, Apple have announced their final event, probably for 2021. The event is simply called
Unleashed.
And what we believe this
Unleashed
means is the power of the brand new MacBook Pros. Last year we got the brand new M1 MacBooks, including the MacBook Pro that we have here, the MacBook Air, and also the Mac Mini. And then following on into 2021, we got the new iMac M1, and we've also even got an iPad Pro M1. Now, this is the second event that Apple are doing this fall. We've already had an event earlier on, about a month ago, and this showed us the brand new Apple Watch Series 7 and also some new iPads, including the brand new design iPad Mini 6, and then also finally the iPhone 13 models. And this event was amazing. A lot of us loved what Apple revealed at this event. So this next event, a lot of you guys are super excited for it, especially for all you Mac fans out there. I will be honest, I am a massive Mac fan myself, and if it was up to me, I'm actually more looking forward to this event than the actual iPhone event. The new chipset, what's expected to go inside the new Macs, has been called the M1X among reporters out there. Now, we don't actually know if the new chipset is actually going to be called the M1X. It could actually be called M2, or it could actually be called something completely different. We just don't know, but everyone keeps referring to it as M1X, and there's some history behind why we actually think this is the case. If we go back years ago with one of the iPads, I think it was actually the iPad 3rd or 4th generation, we actually got an A5X chipset. And what this basically meant was that we got a few more cores on the actual chipset that was inside it compared to the normal A5. And then we've used this kind of X sort of type of chipset going forwards on lots of iPads. In fact, for example, the iPad Pro that came out in 2018 was known as the A12X. And again, it had more cores than the standard A12 chipset that came in the likes of, say, the iPhone XS and the iPhone XR or XR, whatever you want to call it. So most likely that the newer MacBooks, as they are basically going to be more powerful machines, but not really kind of next generation machines, we're expecting it to have an X on the end because we're going to get more cores inside it. And one of those questions you're probably wondering is, well, how many cores will we actually get inside the M1X? Well, right now, the standard M1 chipset actually has 8 cores inside it. It actually has 4 high performance cores and 4 efficiency cores that make up the chipset. We believe that M1X is actually going to have 10 cores inside it. Now you're thinking, well, this is just 2 more cores, it's not that much more. But we believe that Apple are going to be sort of shifting things around a little bit more. Whereas M1 has 4 efficiency cores, we believe that the M1X will actually only have 2 efficiency cores and actually have 8 performance cores, because the M1X chipset in these more higher powerful MacBook Pros are designed for creators, developers, and all sorts of those kind of people out there, whereas the M1 chipset is more of a kind of consumer kind of chipset for your kind of standard kind of tasks. Don't get me wrong, M1 is still going to probably be available, and I do not believe, and a lot of other people out there do not believe, that the M1X chipset is here to take away the M1 generation. Just like this MacBook Pro that I have here, it is an M1 chipset inside it, and I believe Apple are going to continue to sell this actual model for some time to come. And then when the M2 chipset comes along, then they'll take away this MacBook Pro. But again, it might not actually be called the M2 in the future, we might get M2 now, but whatever that next generation chipset will be, and it will have a very, very similar core amount to M1, that is what will replace the M1 MacBook Pro, MacBook Air, iMac M1, and so forth. The other question a lot of you guys are asking is about graphics performance. The M1 chipset does actually have 8 graphical cores inside it, and this is really, really good, and it's quite a powerful chipset for what it is, and especially that everything is built into the same chipset. But we've been told with M1X, it's most likely we're actually going to be getting 16 or 32 cores inside it for graphics power. Well, it's absolutely unbelievable. And if Apple do their usual sort of jiggery-pokery, that's the term I'm going to use, that they make their software work with their M1X chipset, we're going to get some amazing performance. Apple are the pioneers of making hardware and software working together for kind of laptop devices out there. So this is something really, really amazing to look forward to. For actual MacBooks, what are we actually expecting? Well, we're actually expecting a brand new design 16-inch MacBook Pro to replace the current 16-inch MacBook Pro. And we're also expecting a 14-inch MacBook Pro. And this one will replace the higher tier Intel 13-inch MacBook Pros that are still available right now. Now, the reason why these MacBook Pros are still available right now is because it's because of the traditional system that Apple originally had set up. Back in the day before the Apple Silicon M1 chipset came along, Apple used to sell two tiers to each of their MacBook Pros. So you used to have kind of a lower Intel chipset inside one MacBook Pro and a higher tier Intel chipset in another MacBook Pro, and this costs a little bit more. In fact, Apple still do this with the 16-inch MacBook Pro, what is available right now. There's an i7 and there's also an i9, and you can choose between both of these. And this is basically what Apple used to have. But M1 came along and kind of stormed that. So we believe that basically the M1X is going to be the higher tier kind of model, but you'll also get that 14-inch size screen, what is over that 13-inch size screen that we currently have right now with the M1 chipset. Like I said earlier on in this video, the M1 MacBook Pro is going to stay. It's probably not going to disappear at all. Now, for what the actual MacBook Pros will actually feature, the 16-inch and the 14-inch MacBook Pro, it is most likely we're going to get a mini LED display put inside these MacBooks. And this will give us far more better brightness, a higher resolution, and very likely, we've been told, it's going to be a ProMotion display. This is very similar to what we have right now with the iPad Pros, for example. So the 12.9-inch model with that mini LED display. And it's an adaptive screen that will probably be very similar to what we actually have inside the iPhone 13 Pro models that just came out around about a month ago. Other features we're expecting to see are some changes to some of the ports. So right now, the current 16-inch and also the current higher tier 13-inch MacBook Pro have four USB-C ports. And basically, these are just the only ports that are available on it. So if you want to charge up your MacBook Pro, you have to use a USB-C charger, what comes in the box. However, we've been told that Apple have redesigned the MagSafe charger, what has been absent since around about 2015. The reason why MagSafe was probably taken away back in the time then in 2015 is because MacBooks demanded much more power inside it. I don't think Apple had caught up with the technology to make a MagSafe charger that could give out enough power to kind of charge up MacBook Pros quick enough. But we believe that Apple have caught up now, and finally the MagSafe is returning back to the MacBook Pro, and this is really, really exciting. For ports wise though, with USB-C ports, these are expected still to stay on the MacBook Pro 14-inch and the 16-inch model. However, there'll probably only be three of them now because that MagSafe will take away one of those ports. However, don't feel too disheartened that you've got to still plug in hubs and adapters and things to use, like HDMI and your SD card slot. Lots of leaks and reports out there have basically said that the HDMI port and also the SD card slot is returning to the MacBook Pros. So if you're using it for those reasons, hubs and things out there, you won't need to do that. You only just need to use your hubs, for example, for other kind of expansions. So basically changing it from USB-C to normal USB type A, and also using it for other different kind of bits and pieces out there. So this is really, really exciting to see that Apple have kind of turned back on this. So something else likely to change is the disappearance of the Touch Bar. The Touch Bar was introduced in 2016 on the MacBook Pros, and Personally, I don't believe the Touch Bar has hit off as well as Apple thought it would. It was a great idea, it was a great concept, and to be honest, lots of developers out there have created their apps to work with the actual Touch Bar. But generally speaking, including myself here, I'd actually say the only thing I mainly use the Touch Bar for is to adjust the brightness and adjust the sound on my MacBook Pros. And to be honest, if that's the case, then you might as well just have the physical buttons back. Don't get me wrong, I do like the Touch Bar for, like, for example, auto correction options. So for example, if I'm spelling things out, and sometimes it comes up with options above it to say, oh, you've spelt this wrong. A bit like what you get like on your iPhone at the very top bar. This is really, really useful, and this is something I probably would miss. But for other features and other bits and pieces, so for example, when you're inside an app and like a window bar comes up and you have an option to press OK or cancel, this comes up on the Touch Bar as well as the screen. And to be honest, I'm always pressing it on the screen with my mouse. I never really hardly touch it on the Touch Bar. Same with sort of scrubbing through movies, for example, and videos. I don't actually use the Touch Bar for this. As you can tell, I create a lot of videos. So really, I wouldn't miss it for this reason. But overall, the new MacBook Pros sound really, really exciting. We cannot wait to see them at the Apple event called Unleashed. But something else we're really, really excited about on this channel, and that is the giveaway we are doing. And that giveaway is for this. It is for an iPhone 13 Pro Max. And I'm going to be giving this away to one lucky subscriber when we get over 300,000 subscribers. And to be honest, it's not that far away. And all I want to know from you guys in the comments below is what Apple gear are you planning to buy within the next year or so? Write it down in the comments below. And if you're new here, make sure that you subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell, because when we get over 300,000 subscribers, I will be announcing the winner then, and you'll want to get that notification. Now, just a quick note on that as well. If you do get a message in your comments and basically it doesn't look correct and it doesn't look like it's from me, or maybe it's got my profile picture and they've got some weird and random names above them, it is probably not me. Also, the fact, like I just said, I will be announcing the winner after we get 300,000 subscribers. If anybody else tells you you've won a prize before that time, it is not me, and it's from a scammer, sadly. So just ignore these messages or report them. It is up to you. Well, guys, with that out of the way, let's talk about the next thing. Let's talk about the actual day of when this actual event is happening. So if you are a keen Apple fan, you will notice the actual event is actually happening on a Monday. Now, a lot of you out there are going, so what? It's a Monday. Well, this is quite strange, to be honest. Apart from Apple's WWDC, which always starts for like 2 weeks or a week or whatever it is, it's always having its event on a Monday. Every other hardware announcement is generally, over the last sort of 10, 15 years, always on a Tuesday. So why is it happening on a Monday this year? Well, there's possibly an explanation to do with a rival company. And to be honest, it's not actually anything rival to do with the hardware that Apple are going to be releasing. And that company is Google. Google look likely to be doing their event on October 19th. In fact, not looking likely, they are doing their event on October 19th. Now, Apple couldn't really do their event on the same day because you're stealing the thunder. And I'm sure Google would be up in arms about that. And personally, also, it's just disrespectful if Apple did do that. It would be really, really bad. So Apple have done for the next best thing they can do, and that is they could have moved it out a week further. What I personally think what they should have done is that. So it should have happened the Tuesday afterwards. But nope, what they've decided to do is do the event one day early. So they're going to do it on the Monday instead. And to be honest, even doing that is probably going to take some of the limelight away from Google with their event the day after. But there again, like I said, I don't think Apple are going to be really talking about anything to do with iPhones, apart from the successful launch of it. But they won't actually be announcing any kind of updates to the actual physical iPhones themselves, apart from maybe iOS 15.1. And that is probably about it. So really, in another way you could see it, I don't think Google have that much to be scared about. But yeah, that is quite strange that Apple are doing their event on a Monday, but like I said, I think the excuse behind it is to do with the Google Pixel 6 event, what is happening with the day after, and they didn't really want to have that kind of rivalry sort of thing going on there. So finally, the last thing I want to talk about is another product that Apple will probably be announcing at the event, and it is this. Well, This is the current generation. These are the AirPods 2. So right now, if you've been following my channel, you'll notice that there's been lots of videos and lots of leaks and rumors about the brand new AirPods 3. So most likely at this actual Apple event, we're probably going to finally see the launch of the AirPods 3. Now, we've been waiting ages for this. In fact, the AirPods 2 came out about 2.5 years ago, and we were probably actually expecting to see the brand new AirPods back when we had the iPad Pro and the iMac event back in kind of around springtime earlier this year, but it never happened. And then also, it logically made sense, to be honest, that the AirPods came out with the iPhones, because that's, you know, AirPods are most likely to be hooked up to iPhones mostly. Don't get me wrong, you can hook up your AirPods to your MacBook Pro and to your iPads and lots of things, and that's the great thing about the Apple ecosystem. But for them to be released at this event, it is a little bit strange, but you know, we've had loads of leaks and reports out there saying they're waiting inside warehouses to be shipped out. A bit like AirTags at the spring-loaded event. Some people got some AirTags and actually on the box they had a copyright of 2019, even though the AirTags came out in 2021. And that could be a possibility with the actual AirPods. You could have a copyright on there for 2020 because they were intentionally going to come out earlier this year or even end of last year, but it never actually happened. But we believe it's going to be coming out. Now, the new AirPods, we've been told, are probably going to be having a brand new design, and they're going to be taking a lot of features from the AirPods Pro. Don't get me wrong, the AirPods Pro are going to still be the superior sort of AirPods out there, but there'll be a lot of borrowed features and also a brand new design. So there we have it. That is what we're expected to see at the new Apple event. Personally, I believe we'll see the announcement of the AirPods first at the event. That's the first thing that will be talked about, and maybe some other software bits and pieces. But for hardware, it will probably be the AirPods first. And then afterwards, what will be talked about next will be some brand new MacBook Pros with that brand new M1X or whatever that chipset name is going to be. Well, guys, it's time to wrap up this video. So if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press the like button. And also at the same time as well, if you want the latest Apple news, reviews, and comparisons, please also hit that subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time, guys, I will see you really soon. Bye-bye.